Hello friends, we have a CPU here, and it was displaying an error message about the CMOS battery failure, so we replaced the battery. And now the issue is that after changing the battery, when we power on, the display is not showing. If you look at the keyboard lights, then the num lock is already turned on. And if I press the num lock key again to turn on or off it again, then it is responding. So the computer is responding but the display is not working. Let me show you that there is an add-on card attached to the motherboard, a PCI Express card for the display. You can see that the VGA cable is attached to the inbuilt graphic port. So without changing any other configurations, I just detach the VGA cable from the inbuilt port and attach it to the VGA port of the PCI Express display guard. As we have changed the VGA cable and attached it to the PCI Express card, and now I turn off the PC and later turn on it back. You can see that the display is back, and now I will press F2 key to enter the BIOS setup. So I want you to understand why and how this usually happens. For that, we need to move to the configuration tab of the BIOS setup, and here press enter on the video, because our problem is related to the video configuration settings. You can see the first option in the video configuration page is the integrated graphics device, and it is set to enable if primary. This option indicates either you want to enable or disable the inbuilt graphic port. As the default is already configured to enable if primary, which means that the inbuilt graphic port, either VGA, DVI or HDMI, will only work if that is configured as the primary graphics device. So that further means, as the default settings after changing the CMOS battery for integrated graphics devices is set to enable if primary, and as we have installed an add-on graphics card, so the add-on card has automatically become the primary graphics card. And that is why our inbuilt graphics card get disabled, as our VGA cable was previously connected with the inbuilt graphics card. And after installing the add-on card became the primary graphics card. So that is why there was no display on the screen, because the output was being sent to the add-on card. Whereas the VGA cable was connected to the inbuilt graphics port. So I will suggest you to set the integrated graphics device option to always enable. So that either you use multiple monitors or not, both of your graphics port will be working conditions. So you can check these options in most of the BIOS. And here you can also see that primary video adapter option is set to auto. So what that actually means. It means when you will turn on the computer, then BIOS will automatically decide that which adapter should remain the primary, the add-on, or the inbuilt one. As this BIOS setting was automatically making the add-on card as the primary card, and the inbuilt as secondary. So that is why there was no display on the screen after installing an add-on card. So here you can also configure that which graphic card you want to make your primary graphics card during system boot. So if I configure the integrated graphics as the primary card, then I must also plug the VGA cable to inbuilt graphic port. Let's say I change that to be integrated graphics as our primary card, and save the changes with the F10 key. Let's see if there is any display on the screen. You can see that there is no display on the screen. I turn the PC off again, change the wire from add-on card to the inbuilt VGA port, and turn on the PC back again. Now, the integrated graphics device has now become the primary graphics device. So, I hope you will like this tutorial.